Welcome back, children. In this audio, let's look at the second part of the story. Please look at page number 10. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach, from which blood was flowing. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered it with his handkerchief, but the blood would not stop flowing. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. The man felt better and asked for something to drink. The king brought fresh water and gave it to him. By this time the sun had set and the air was cool. The king, with the hermit's help, carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. The man closed his eyes and lay quiet. The king, tired by his walk and the work he had done, lay down on the floor and slept through the night. When he awoke, it was several hours before he could remember where he was or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. Now, in the previous scene, we saw that a man coming running towards the hermit and the king. When he reached near the king, he suddenly fainted and fell to the ground. He had pressed his hand against his stomach, from which the blood was flowing so badly. Immediately the king and the hermit removed his clothing and found the wound in his stomach. The king washed this wound and covered it with his handkerchief, but the blood did not stop flowing. So he redressed it again until the bleeding stopped. When the man felt a bit relief, he asked the king for some water, and the king brought some fresh water for him. After that, the king and the hermit carried this wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. By then, the king became very tired. We know that he had been working for the hermit. So the king lay down on the floor and slept. When he awoke, he didn't understand where he was or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. "I do not know you and have nothing to forgive you for," said the king. "You do not know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who swore revenge on you because you put my brother to death and seized my property. I knew you had gone alone to see that hermit, and I made up my mind to kill you on your way home. But the day passed and you did not return. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard, who recognized me and wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. I wished to kill you and you have saved my life. Now, if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and will order my sons to do the same. Forgive me." So, as I said, the king was not able to recall where he was and didn't understand who the bearded man was. But he saw the man asking for his forgiveness in a very weak voice. So the king was quite surprised to hear that, because he didn't understand who he was and he didn't know for what reason he has to forgive this person. It's then the bearded man said that he was the enemy of the king, who swore to take revenge on him. Why? Because the king had put his brother to death and seized his property. Because of that reason, he planned to kill the king. So when he knew that the king had gone to the hermit alone, he planned to kill the king on his way home. But the king was late to return, so he left his hiding place. The king's bodyguard recognized him and wounded him. It was then he reached the hermit's place. Now, if the king had not saved his life, if the king had not dressed his wound, he would have died by this time. So he felt guilty for his action and asked king's forgiveness. He also assured that he would be one of the most faithful servants of the king and will order his sons to serve the king. The king was very happy to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have won him over as a friend. He not only forgave him but said he would send his servants and his own doctor to look after him, and he promised to give back the man his property. The king not only forgave the wounded man but also said that he would send his servants and his own doctor to take care of him, and also promised to give back this man's property. Leaving the wounded man, the king went out of the hut and looked round for the hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to get answers to his questions. The hermit was on his knees, sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. The king went up to the hermit and said, "For the last time, I beg you to answer my questions, wise man." Now, after the conversation with the wounded man, he went to the hut and searched for the hermit, because till now the king has not received any answers for his questions. So he saw that the hermit was on his knees, sowing seeds in the beds. So he went to the hermit and requested once again, "For the last time, I beg you to answer my questions," the king said. "You have already been answered," said the hermit, still bending down to the ground and looking up at the king as he stood before him. "How have I been answered? What do you mean?" "Do you not see?" replied the hermit. "If you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug these beds for me, you would have gone away. Then that man would have attacked you, and you would have wished you had stayed with me. So the most important time was when you were digging the beds. And I was the most important man, and to do me good was your most important business. Afterwards, when the man ran to us, the most important time was when you were caring for him, because if you had not dressed his wounds, he would have died without having made peace with you. So he was the most important man, and what you did for him was your most important business. Remember then, there is only one time that is important, and that time is now. It is the most important time because it is the only time we have any power to act. The most necessary person is the person you are with at a particular moment, for no one knows what will happen in the future and whether we will meet anyone else. The most important business is to do that person good, because we were sent into this world for that purpose alone." So when the hermit said that he had been answered for all his questions, the king was quite surprised at hearing this. Why? Because he has not got any direct answers, right? But then the hermit explained, "See, if the king had not pitied the hermit's weakness on the previous day and helped him to dig these beds, he would have gone away from that place, and then he would have been attacked by the enemy. So at that point of time, the most important time for the king was when he was digging the beds. At that point of time, helping the hermit was the most important thing for the king to do. And the hermit was the most important person for him. After that, when the wounded man came to them, that was the most important time for them. Because if he had not helped this wounded man to dress his wounds, he would have died then. So at that time, the wounded man was the most important man for the king, and to help him was the most important business for the king. And the hermit states that the most important time is always now, because we do not know what will happen in future, whether we will be able to do anything, whether we'll be alive. We don't know all these things. It's unpredictable. Life is quite unpredictable, isn't it? So the most necessary person for everyone is the person that we are with at a particular moment, because we never know what will happen in the future or whether we will meet anyone else. And the most important business for all of us is to do good to that person who is next to us at this moment, because We are sent to this world to help the person who's next to us. As we say, charity begins from home. So what we all have to understand is, we don't have to keep thinking a lot on how to help others or what is the best time to do something and all. We just have to focus on the present moment and the person who is next to us. Always keep in mind that the person who is next to us is the most important for us. He is the person who needs our care and attention the most at this particular time. If we have that intention in our mind, definitely the things will fall in right place. Because ultimately, we are sent to this world to help others. So this is the message, this is the beautiful message that the writer Leo Tolstoy has tried to give us. Hope you have enjoyed the lesson, children. Thank you.